Today you're going to learn how to combine data from multiple cells. So for example, you have values in multiple cells and you want to combine them in a meaningful way. I'm also going to show you a bonus trick where you have text and number combined, but Excel doesn't see the text part, completely ignores it. This way you can use this text and number combination in your formulas. You can use it in the sum function and calculate totals. Sounds interesting, right? Let's take a look. Okay, so here we have name and amount, and we want to combine these in a dynamic way, so that if our cell values change, the result is automatically going to be updated. We're going to start off with an equal sign, go and select A2, now use an ampersand to combine this value with the value in another cell. You're not restricted to two cells, you can combine this with any number of cells that you want. You would just continue and put in the next ampersand, select your cell, until you're done with your selection. In this case, we just want to combine these two values, and I get Bill and 1000 stuck together. This doesn't look so good. It's going to be better if we add a space in between. To do that, edit your formula right after the first ampersand, put in the quotation marks. In here, you can add any type of text that you want. If you just want a space, put in a space, put in the quotation mark again. But check this out. If you try to leave the formula right now, you're going to get this error. There's something wrong with it. It's not complete yet. The problem is that you cannot combine text directly with a cell reference. What you need in between is this ampersand. Don't forget to add that in there. Once you do that, you get Bill space 1000. Now, if you want to add something else in there, so if you want to add a dash, you can do that, or space, dash, space, and our result updates automatically. Now, we can easily just double click and send this down and get these in a dynamic way. Because they're formulas, if I update any of these names here, the result is automatically going to be updated. So I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. Now, in case you want your numbers to be formatted properly, so let's say in this case I wanted to show that this is $1,000, I can do that as well. I'm just going to remove that dash, so we're just going to go back to the space, and just before the number, I'm going to type in the dollar sign. Press Enter, and now we have Bill, $1,000. If I send this down, Jessica, $1,000, and so on. If you want to have more space, you can add that inside the quotation marks. Now, what if you wanted your numbers to have proper formatting? So you want to have the thousand separator in there. This is where things can get tricky. An easy way around this is to use the text function. So I'm just going to go back to what we had before. And right here, where I'm referencing the cell that has the number, I'm going to use the text function. This function can convert a value and format it as a text. The great thing is you can add any type of number formatting that you want. So let's say I want to add a thousand separator. What I need to do is, in quotation marks, define that format. Now, it can be difficult to remember what these formats are, and if you're new to Excel, you're probably not going to know what the format is. So let me show you an easy way to format this. I'm just going to put a double quotation mark here just so I can close off this formula and leave that. I just want to show you what happens when I press Enter. I'm going to get nothing because I'm making this number disappear. I'm formatting it as nothing. I'm kind of like hiding that number. I don't want to do that. I want to show it with a thousand separator. But how do I know what to type in here? Here's what you can do. Just right mouse click on any cell and go to Format Cells. You can also use the shortcut key Control 1. Go all the way down to Custom and you're going to see how a thousand separator looks. In my case, because I have US regional settings, my thousand separator is a comma and my decimal is a dot. So just pick the number formatting that you want. I want this one. I'm going to press Control C and copy it. Click on OK. Go here and inside quotation marks, paste this in. Now this hash and zeros are just placeholders for numbers, but you don't really have to understand what these are. You just have to recognize that this is a thousand separator. Now when I press Enter, I get my numbers formatted properly. Before we wrap up, I have a bonus tip for you. Let's say in this case, we have two columns. One is for amount base, another one is for bonus. On the bottom, I want to show the total value. So here, I've used the sum function to calculate the total. Then I've used the text function to add the thousand separator to this. And then I've combined it with the word base. In the end, I get my total base of 7,200. I've used a similar function here, except that I want this to be called bonus. Now on this side here, I just want to sum these two values. What's the problem here though? Can I just do this? No, right? Because I'm just summing text. These cells are no longer seen as numbers. They are seen as text. Here's how you can disguise these numbers to look exactly like this, but be recognized by Excel as numbers. So you don't need to do all of this. All you need is just to get the sum of the cells above, pull this across, and now check this out. I want this to have the word base in it. So I'm gonna right mouse click, format cells, go to custom, keep that thousand separator formatting, and just go to the side here, in quotation marks, type in whatever text you want. In this case, I'm gonna put in base, colon, add a space, and quotation mark again. So we can see how it looks like here. Click on OK, and we see the text base in there, but this is being recognized as a number. It's showing up here. So we can do the same thing for this one. We're gonna press Control 1, go all the way to custom. If I wanted to reuse that formatting, I can. You're gonna find it down here. Let's just adjust this and call this bonus. So here we're disguising our numbers to look like text, but in fact they are numbers. So those are the different ways you can combine text and numbers together. Let me know what you think. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that thumbs up, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet, and I'm gonna see you in the next video.